Our friends at Go Providence has brought us Chef Ryan Meier from Pamfilio's today, and we have pork chops that just have made this kitchen smell fantastic. Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here today. This is a great meal, easy to make.
Relatively
easy, and you're going to show us how to do this morning. But first, we need to go over the ingredients because you got a lot of stuff going on over here.
Okay, we have a roasted pork chop. We have some apples for pork chops and applesauce. Dehydrated lemons and limes, fresh coriander, salt, pepper, black, some fresh parsley, olive oil, of course, and some butternut squash.
Very nice. All right, let's talk about the pork chop itself, because this is, you're keeping it on the bone.
Yep, absolutely.
Always better to keep it on the bone because of the flavor, right?
Flavor, fat content. Everybody doesn't want to hear about fat, but fat's good.
Right.
We all like it. This is a pork loin that was roasted.
Okay.
And then we let it rest, and then we cut it off, and then we sear it.
Okay, where should we go to get something like this? Because is this something we're going to get at our regular market?
You can get it at your regular markets. You can go to Shaw's or Stop and Shop or Dave's Market and ask for a pork roast bone-in, and they'll give you one, and then you can just season it up the way we're going to show you how to do it, and then you can make this dish for your family. You can leave it whole. You can do it the way I'm going to do it, break it down and sear it off.
Right.
So there's multiple applications to it.
Okay, pork chop, great. Okay, and then you have this too, which
butternut squash, which
you can't go wrong with butternut squash.
You know, it's available. It's around all year long. People think it's really hard and complicated to use. It's you got to peel it, you got to cut it, toss it with some olive oil, some salt, pepper.
I love it.
Throw it in the oven. Forget about it. Come back. There it is.
You're Rhode Islander. Forget about it.
Forget about it.
And then you have these apples here that also look, they look beautiful too.
Applesauce goes back to a favorite TV show, Pork Chops and Applesauce. I've been doing it for since I was a kid. You know, just not so mushy and not out of,
right.
out of a can.
Okay.
And a little spicy from the peppers.
Well, we are looking forward to this morning. You're going to be able to make this tonight at home. If you want to do that, we are going to show you how to do it. We're going to start putting all this stuff together in just a little bit. Back to you.
And Chef Brian joins us again from Pamfilio's, and we are making pork chops.
Pork
and
chops applesauce. And applesauce.
Isn't that swell?
Yeah.
Okay. Where do we begin?
We started with a pork loin that we roasted to 100 degrees, and then we cut them off into chops, and we're going to sear off those chops with some olive oil,
okay,
salt, and fresh coriander.
Okay, you're putting the salt in there first, not on the
yeah,
pork chop
as an abrasive.
Woo!
And it keeps it from sticking.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
Everybody
has worries about things being stuck, and you don't have to. You got a hot pan, and you got some salt and some oil, and nothing will stick.
Nice. What were those? What was that last ingredient that you put in?
That was coriander.
Okay.
Fresh coriander.
Get the fan on a little bit. We got a little smoke happening in the kitchen right now. So about how long will we cook this on each side?
Each side, 3 to 4 minutes, because it has been brought up to an internal temperature of about 135 degrees from 110 while it rests. It goes up to 135. So now
is that
just,
is that a safe temperature to eat pork?
Yeah, years ago, cook it well done, cook it, kill it. Today, pork is raised so much better than it used to be 30 years ago. Mm-hmm. So there's no trichinosis anymore. It really very small amount. Chance of that. So medium and medium rare is actually, temperatures of pork now.
And you have this on high heat?
This is on,
I can tell by that sizzle.
We're cooking.
Beautiful.
A little longer on that side.
And you keep this whole when you serve it, correct?
The chop is served whole on the bone. My philosophy is if someone serves you a bone, you're allowed to pick it up and eat it.
Yes.
Because to me, that's the best part.
Yeah, why not? And I think, I'm sure too, a lot of the flavors stay in there when you keep it on the bone.
It's like, oops.
We got another one.
As my grandfather used to say, the meat is always sweeter next to the bone. So I go with that philosophy.
Hey, why not? That is a beautiful piece. How large is that again?
That's about 12 ounces. 12 to 14 ounces, some of that neighborhood, maybe a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
Cut them with a double rib. You can do a bigger chop if you want to do something like for, dinner for two.
Yep.
This is about a normal portion at the restaurant.
Great. It smells good. That's a nice sized portion there. We're going to finish up the rest of the dish when we come back.
Awesome.
Thanks to Go Providence for bringing us Pamfilio's. We have Chef Brian here today. We got pork chops on the menu, and it is great looking.
Mm-hmm.
Great looking. All right, so this has been in the pan for a little while. How long does this cook? Because that's a pretty big pork chop.
Well, we roasted the whole pork loin first. We seasoned it with salt, pepper, fresh coriander, and we roasted the whole thing wrapped in tin foil for about 2.5 to 3 hours.
So this is going to fall apart.
Well, it's treated like a rib. Okay. Absolutely. Same idea, low and slow.
Yep.
So about 110 temperature internally.
Mm-hmm.
We pull it out. We jam it in the walk-in. We let it cool.
Right.
In the foil, in its own fat, per se.
Yep. Right.
And then the next day we go out and we cut the chops out. And you saw an earlier shot of its pinkness and mm-hmm. juiciness. And at this point, all you need to do is sear it and serve it because... Yeah.
A couple minutes each side, you said?
Yeah. Don't, pork, the misconception of pork is cook it. Trichinosis from a long, long time ago. Today, it's raised totally different.
Mm-hmm.
So the chances of that is very slim to none.
Okay.
Medium.
Right.
It's great. It's juicy. It's a great piece of meat. Why,
nice.
Why,
nice.
Why overcook
that started, and a couple different sides that we're pairing with this, too.
Yeah, butternut squash, around all the time.
Who doesn't love butternut
squash?
It's something that I feel like you have a craving for it all fall.
Yeah.
Yep.
And you start to forget about it after the new year. But I'll tell you what, hey, we still have some chilly days. You want a nice comfort meal like this one and throw some butternut squash in the mix.
You can cut it down. You can saute it. We make a soup out of it. Take it, roast it down just the way it is now. Puree with some heavy cream, heat it up, boom, you got a nice soup.
And see, even look at those apples favorites in the pan, too, because you're going to make an applesauce, right?
Yeah, applesauce, some Fuji apples, some peppers, some spicy peppers. There's a little bit of a dehydrated lemon and lime that I make at the restaurant for sugar content to it. Again, just cooked down simply, not mushy, textures are everything today. So it's a combination of a lot of little things.
Yeah, it looks great. But okay, where do
back
we see
to the
it
roots.
Now?
What do we need to do?
What do we need to do? We can eat the plate.
Okay, we've got a plate. We've got a plate here.
We can plate. We can eat. I personally put down the butternut squash sauce first.
I'll put this right. Oh, you want me to?
You can put it down.
Okay, I'll put it right there.
I'll try not to burn you.
I'll put it right in front of you.
Awesome.
So this is a nice twist on the classic, you know, pork chops and applesauce.
Right, it's exactly where it comes from.
Just a cooked apple instead.
Yeah, instead of kill it and make sauce out of it. And I put the apple underneath because the pork chop looks so yummy.
Yeah.
And it really does.
Simple
it looks
like
so good.
That. You can put a little bit on top, a little juice.
What seasonings went into the apple?
Apples is simple syrup, a little bit of fresh honey, papadou juice, the papadou juice.
Oof. Ooh, a little drizzle of honey.
A little honey makes everybody happy.
Wow.
As we call it, making it Italian, even though it's not Italian. A little apple, a little extra virgin olive oil.
That looks
That looks really good.
Now, is this a special that you have, or is this like a staple on the menu?
This is actually a new pork chop. I have a pork chop on the menu I've been doing forever. This is a friend of mine that came in, brought me some sausage that's done with coriander. He hates fennel. so I decided to make this pork chop in his honor because I've been stealing sausage from him since I was a kid. and his homemade wine. So I made this, and this is going to be on the new menu, which is coming out hopefully at the end of the week.
So what are some other things then that we can look forward to?
The butternut squash is going to be on there. There's a summer pasta that's coming on with zucchini, yellow squash ribbons, pappardelle, fresh basil. Kind of light and summery. What else are we working on? There's a couple other things, a couple other clam dishes.
And give the address out so that today, later on today, when you do open the doors, you get a line around the block waiting for this.
Awesome.
Waiting for this.
If we do that, we're going to be in trouble. 1800 Menden Road in Cumberland, Rhode Island.
Okay.
In the same plaza as Planet Fitness.
All right.
So, relatively easy to get to.
Nice.
I would say so. All right. Will, you're eyeing
that. Yeah, we're going to chop this up and have a little...
I think you need like a...
Yeah, we need a...
You need a knife.
Here you go. You need, like, one
this.
Of those knives.
It's kind of a small knife.
All right, well...
Wait, you want this one instead?
I don't think it can handle that
there, one. There are some options.
We'll chop this. Yep. Get a little taste of this, because it really does.
Like
it looks
said,
so,
it,
so good.
With it staying on the bone there, all of those natural
That's
juices...
That's the best piece right the end.
And you can really see how great it looks inside. So give this a shot.
But does it taste just as great?
Yes, it does. Mmm. Really good.
Beautiful. All right, if you want to try and make this at home, or heck, just see them for Chef Brian to cook it for you, we'll put all the details on our website, it's WPRI.com.